Welcome to session 6. In this session, we are going to study biasing in MOS amplifier circuits. So therefore, this particular session is related with the MOSFETs then. So we know that MOSFET, nothing but metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistors. So they also have major application as switch and amplifiers. So therefore, when MOSFETs are used as amplifiers, then obviously, so we need to design biasing circuit for them also. So therefore, now this particular topic is concerned with, so how to bring about biasing in MOS amplifier circuits. So therefore, we are going to study the different biasing techniques, like biasing by fixing VGS and biasing by fixing VG. So here, you need to recall some of the basics regarding the MOSFET and its terminology. Okay, so even in electronic devices also, so we have discussed, so a MOSFET has three terminals: gate, drain and the source. So here, whenever we write VGS, it means voltage between gate and source terminal. So when source is grounded, then VGS can be written as equal to VG. So similarly, whenever you find VDS, it means it is the voltage between drain and the source terminals. Okay, and another important notation concerned with the MOSFETs is the drain current ID. So therefore, by just looking at these equations, you may recall the remaining equations as well as terms associated with the MOSFETs. So now let us begin with what is this technique, biasing by fixing VGS. So therefore, in MOS amplifier circuits, okay, so in order to give the DC biasing to them, this is the most basic and simplest method of fixing the bias voltage. Okay, so here bias voltage is nothing but the VGS, gate to source voltage. Okay, and you can observe the notation capital V and capital GS. So it indicates it is a DC voltage. Okay, so even though it is a most straightforward approach, okay, but it is still not a very preferable approach. Okay, because finally, when we have to bias an amplifier circuit, what is required is a constant VGS. So therefore, we can think of giving a constant VGS directly from the power supply. But that will not serve as a very good approach because of some of the reasons. So now to understand those reasons, we need to go through the drain current equations here. So we know that the drain current equation, particularly in the saturation region, it is given by ID equal to 1 by 2 mu n C oxide into W by L VGS minus VT whole square. Now in this drain current equation, so starting from the LHS, ID means the drain current, DC drain current, and mu n, it means mobility of the carriers, C oxide is the oxide capacitance, then W is width, L is length of the channel. So this is regarding the this is related with the transistor geometry, and then VGS is of course gate to source voltage. So this is the one we are talking about now, and VT is nothing but the threshold voltage. Okay, so therefore in saturation region, the drain current equation is given by this equation. So therefore now whenever we use this method, that is taking the device in saturation region by giving a fixed value of VGS, then the problem here is the threshold voltage as well as oxide capacitance and this aspect ratio, W by L ratio of the device, they vary from device to device, which are of the same size and same type. That is, these parameters slightly vary, okay, from device to device. So because of this, the fixing VGS will not help. Okay, and also this variation is still large. Okay, so in the devices which are fabricated on the different wafers, and also the difference is still more between different batches of the wafers also. Okay, and along with these two conditions, both the threshold voltage as well as this mobility factor, they also depend on the temperature. Okay, so therefore due to these reasons, so whenever this kind of biasing, that is biasing directly by fixing VGS itself, is used, okay, so then that kind of approach is not considered as a good method of biasing. So because here a graphical plot is shown, so which shows a lot of variation in the drain current values. So whenever the devices are changed. So for example, in this figure only, what is this figure is concerned with? It is showing large variations in the drain currents for the two devices which are selected from the same unit, which are of the same type. Okay, so whenever this fixed VGS biasing technique is used. See, now in this picture you can see that there are two characteristic curves. Okay, so it is ID and VGS curve for device 1 and device 2. So in a batch, two devices are considered. For two devices, curves are plotted. So device 1 graph, device 2 graph is there. And whenever there is a little bit change in the gate to source voltage value, so we can see that for device 1, where is the drain current? It is ID1. Okay, and for the device 2, when same VGS is provided, it behaves differently. In the sense, its ID2 is much more greater than ID1. Okay, so this is not preferred. Okay, because this difference in drain currents is going to change the DC operating point in the circuit. Okay, so what this graph is showing finally is when you consider two different devices and when they are operated with the same VGS, same gate to source voltage value, because our scheme is what? Our scheme is fixed VGS biasing. Okay, so for the both the devices we are fixing the VGS, but we find that the device gives two different drain currents for the same value of VGS. Okay, so therefore, because of this much difference, okay, so this is not considered as a stable biasing technique. Therefore, there is another alternate method is available in order to bias the amplifier circuits. So what is this? The second method is biasing by fixing the gate voltage VG. Okay, so in this circuit there is a resistor RS is also there, which is connected to the source lead. And from the circuit diagram, okay, as shown in figure, it's possible to write what is the total gate voltage. Okay, so VG is equal to, it is a simple KVL equation in the input side loop. Okay, it will be equal to VGS plus RS into ID. RS is a source resistor, ID is the current flowing through that. Therefore, VG equal to VGS plus RS into ID. Now, in this circuit, okay, so this is better than the previous arrangement. How it is better? So now here what happens is, if VG is made very much greater than this VGS value, then minute differences in the VGS will be swamped by the gate voltage VG. Okay, it is going to, that higher value of VG is going to cover those differences. And also here the drain current will be determined by both VG as well as RS. Okay, and also another function of this RS is, so RS is going to stabilize the value of the bias current. Okay, even when the gate voltage VG is not very much greater than VGS. So what is the meaning of this is, suppose, assume that for any reason the drain current is going to increase. Okay, the value of ID increases. Now according to this equation, when we have fixed VG, okay, so when ID increases, in order to satisfy this equation, VG equal to VGS plus RS into ID, VGS has to decrease. Okay, so when ID increases, RS into ID increases. Okay, but VGS has to reduce, so that again the sum is equal to VG. When VGS reduces, obviously the drain current will go down. Okay, so therefore now the reverse operation has occurred. Okay, so when drain current is reduced, it will come back to the correct value. So this is known as a degeneration action, and since RS does this, this is known, RS is known as a degeneration resistance. That is, the RS tries to keep the drain current almost constant. Okay, so this is how this biasing technique by fixing VG will try to give a fixed or a constant biasing to the amplifier circuit. Now, the performance of this biasing circuit is shown here in this graphical representation. Here also it is a graph of ID and VGS. Okay, you can see it's a plot of ID and VGS, where the graph is again plotted for device 1 and device 2, two devices taken from the same batch. See now, when compared to the previous diagram, okay, so now device 1 is given VGS1, device 2 is given VGS2, okay, and device 1 after receiving VGS1, its drain current is ID1, and for device 2 with VGS2 as a gate to source voltage, its drain current is ID2. So even though there is a more difference between VGS1 and VGS2, but the difference in the drain currents is very small. So it means whenever at the input side the biasing voltage slightly changes, it doesn't cause much difference in the drain current values. That in that way the drain current is somewhat stabilized. Okay. So here there is a straight line which is intersecting these curves, and its slope depends on the value of Rs. So here slope is equal to minus 1 by Rs. Okay. So you know that the difference can be still reduced. This difference can be still reduced if the slope value is still reduced. So therefore, this is what is the advantage of using the fixed VG technique. So now, in order to extract this constant voltage VG, some practical circuitry is there. Okay, a practical discrete circuit is implemented. So now, this particular circuit is utilizing one power supply, that is VDD. So you can see that there are resistors RG1 and RG2 are used, so which are of very high value in mega ohms range, and VG gate voltage VG is derived through these resistors. Okay, so VG will be equal to RG2 by RG1 plus RG2 into VDD. Okay, so that is how so VG will be made available at this terminal. Okay. And also, since we the here gate current IG is equal to 0, so obviously RG1 and RG2 are very high. And here, there is a drain resistor RD, okay, and the value of this RD is also selected as large as to obtain a very high gain, but still its value is selected in a such a way that it should be enough to get a desired signal swing without any distortion. Okay. So of course RS is nothing but it is the resistor connected to the source which is going to give us a degeneration action. So now this is the practical discrete circuit, so which will bring about that biasing technique. So in this session, so we have discussed in case of MOS amplifier circuits, okay, so what are the biasing circuitries that are available, and what are the disadvantages associated with the very first technique, that is by fixing VGS, okay, and later on by changing that scheme to another scheme where VG is derived through an external voltage divider circuitry. So how biasing can be improved. So later in the next session we will see through an example so how our practical discrete circuit is successful in giving a good bias to the MOSFET amplifier circuits. Okay. So this is a reference. Thank you.